to weave at an early age, 12 years old. We were all part of a kapahaka team, so we had to learn to make our own pupu. And so some of those techniques are used in korowai making. Then from there, I moved to Auckland and was taught by a kuia at Ngāti Whātua. And have been teaching weaving since I was 19. This particular korowai was given to me to take care of in the when I returned home from LA in 1989, and it has been with my family since. There were other artifacts that came with it, and it was our task to find the owners. The only thing that remains with me at this time is the korowai. This is kiwi, and then the feathers here, the smaller feathers, are a tui. And the fibre is flax fibre. And it's been what we call fatu, which is finger twining, to put it together. What little knowledge I have, most korowai were made as a collective, not just one individual. I think in the time that this was made, there were probably a lot more kiwi than we have today. So you won't find too many cloaks being made for kiwi feather. We have to have access through the Department of Conservation. A lot of hapu are taking back guardianship of these taonga, and people like myself are going to different iwi and teaching how to weave korowai and how to use and prepare feathers. There's a pelting process. So now we have to go to dock. We make an application to get some feathers. And if you're from a particular or a specific iwi or hapu, they will try and find the birds that have been tagged from that area. And you make the application, and then the kaupapa usually is that people want to make it for their marae, hapu or iwi. So often an individual will ask if they can have feathers, apply for feathers. But my teaching has always been that we do it collectively. So to make an average size korowai, you're looking at, for someone my size, you're looking at about, up here, about 35, 40 kiwi. Because of the size of the kiwi are bigger up here. Auckland South is slightly smaller, so you're looking about 50 kiwi to make a full feathered cloak. I like to use my feathers still on the pelt, so I pelt the kiwi, and then I have left and right that I can use, kind of apply it to the base of my corowai, just like it would be on the bird. There's a kiwi feather cloak that was made in Te Whaiti, down in the Bay of Plenty. And originally their feathers came from the north. So in early 2000, I used to weave with a kaumātua called Eddie Maxwell. So he requested some feathers from up here because they were the same size as the ones on his cloak. So he repaired them and then returned the rest of the pelt. So there used to be a lot of trading going on with taonga, like kiwi feathers. One passion that I have is that I can teach as many people as I can to weave. You know, and it doesn't matter what it looks like as long as they learn the process and they learn the tikanga and the knowledge that goes with making.